Remember back in the day when we created our morph video to kind of explain the new evolution system that was similar to the Indrix, and we created our video, everything was great. Now that I actually have all of the pieces to actually properly show you the evolutions, I will get that created and show you guys how it works out. So just remember, every event gives you a specific set of pieces, and then you collect your stuff, you evolve. So every time you evolve, you have to recollect your pieces. So let's get going to summon the pet. So this is the unstable Morpholith. See, isn't it cute? So now that he is done, you'll notice we have to recollect it again, which is fine, right? And then this is to get your hands on the skin. So once we create the skin, we're gonna lose our Morpholith, which is, of course, right? So now we're gonna summon that. Deadland Scorcher skin has been added. Okay, we will take a look at that in a second. Oh, I like how she's still doing. Oh, there we go. Okay. So now, I don't know why the Scorcher skin is still showing up here. This shouldn't be here, because you cannot create the skin multiple times. So I feel like that is wrong. This should not be here anymore. So ignoring that, now going into the Jubilee event is where you're gonna first start collecting the pieces to get your hands on the personality. So the Jubilee event will give you the first two pieces. This time they're stacking two. So there's still there's still 10 tickets each, and the Jubilee event gives us 39 tickets, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. I could be wrong. So it's still 3 tickets per day during that time. So yeah, so basically going into the next event, what you're gonna do is you're gonna go evolution piece, pet piece. Unless you're already caught up and you have a bunch of extra pet pieces, that's usually how I recommend it. That way you're caught up going into everything, so that way potentially you do not miss out on anything. Let's show you now what the skin looks like really quickly. Nordic. If we take, there we go. So this is what the skin looks like. So when the Jester event is done, you will no longer be able to get the skin. So I understand, like, not everybody likes the skins. I get it. Makes sense, right? But like I mentioned before, it is a limited time thing. It's worth collecting. Even if you're not going to use it, it's still something rare. So I still recommend you pick it up if you can. Obviously, at this point in time for the events, if you have just started, don't bother going for it unless you're going to buy your event tickets. Because obviously, you know, you're not going to have enough time. If you're okay with buying your tickets, definitely pick it up. Otherwise, wait and start going for the, Firewalker pieces when the Jubilee event comes. If you still have any questions, please comment on the video. And I will try to clarify it as much as possible. Come see me in stream, and I will answer questions. If this is still rather confusing, you can take a look at my old video and see if that makes a little bit more sense. But just remember, every single time you evolve, you have to recollect the pieces. So now that the first quarter section is done, let's just say skin is gone now, right? Let's say. We're going into the personality. After the personality, we're going into the mount and then the house. So there's still 3 more major collectibles for this year involving the unstable Morpholith. So get excited, because I know I'm pretty happy and I can't wait to see what all these things look like. So yeah, that is it. I hope you guys enjoy the video. Hopefully it all makes sense, and I'll see you guys later.